very good day to our esteemed panel. We are aviation consultants from Malaysian Skyline Aviation Consultancy. Please allow us to introduce ourselves. My name is Nilia Jayasingha, metric number 21817323.
Myself, Ahmed Sharif, my metric number 21900.
I'm Priti Aman, and my metric number is 21900063.
And I'm Fazan Yusuf, and my metric number is 21900068.
Okay. Please allow us to give an introductory overview of the airport. So, the airport of choice is Subang Airport, or in Malay, we call it Lapangan Terbang Sultan Abdul Aziz Shah. And the airport terminal name is Sky Park Terminal. IATA code SZB or Sierra Zulu Bravo. ICAO code WMSA or Whiskey Mike Sierra Alpha. The airport is located in Malaysia, in particular, Subang Petaling District in Selangor. And our current business model is 1.96 million, which is NPPA of 1.96 million passengers as per current update in 2019. So for this section, I'm going to pass it over to my colleague, Fazan.
Thank you, Ms. Lia. So now I'm going to explain regarding the overview layout for the airport. So now I'm going to talk about the landside. What we have the landside, basically this one is the concourse area. And the next one is, this one is the check-in zone. On the landside, we have the check-in zone. This is the view of the check-in zone where are all the passengers checking their luggage and checking their tickets. And the next one is the public transport counters where you can try to find the public transport such as taxi, buses, or grab car maybe. And the next one is the signage. This is the signage we have for the passengers to find the easy way to, especially to the terminal, gates, and the counter for the check-in. Next, this is the check-in kiosk they have, and this is a bag wrapper. So this is the basic facilities that are located at the land side. And this one is the food court area. And this is the recreational facilities such as the flight simulator. They also got, they have equipped the recreational flight simulator just for the public users. And next is the terminal building upgrades and their modifications. What we're going to talk about this one is regarding the annexes that need to be considered as annexes. Number four, standardizing the airport and operations. So, as per our research, we have made our conclusion to make two recommendations for the airport upgrading, which is the first one is the expanding terminal. And the second one is the implementation of 0% manpower. So now we proceed to the terminal building upgrades and modification. The first one is the smart vending machine we have here for, and next is airport buggy, car services, and etc. This basically give the cost efficiency. The next one is the IoT era, which is the more to a technical, like machines that don't use the manpower, less use the manpower, like they're using the electrical e-gate and the e-baggage handling services. And now we're moving to expanding the terminal. So basically this is the map of the Subang Airport. Okay, this is the area that we're going to expand it. Like a chunk of land here, we're going to cut it and to expand it the plan of the airport. So basically this is our plan of the airport, and this area is the new plan of the airport, which is the to accommodate for the 4 aircraft to the Mr. Sharif for the airfield operation.
Thank you for that. So now we look into the airfield upgrades and modification. For that we need to look into the current overview of the overview of the current layout and facility in the asset which is located in Subang Airport. Let's start with the current stack concept, which is the existing one is the PR concept that is followed by Subang Airport. And the current runway configuration will be this area, as you can see. The runway length consists of 3.8 kilometers, and performance strength is as found. And let's go to the airfield modification upgrades. Before the modification upgrades, we need to consider a few annexes, such as Annex 4, which means an aeronautical chance, and Annex 6, operations of aircraft. Since we are opting new aircraft, which is like Code F aircraft, which is completely new and big, we need to consider the whole operation of aircraft. And next is Annex 17, which is security. So it's all about security base we need to consider, and Annex 19, which is safety management system. So basically, we are adopting a new environment where we opting a new kind of aircraft which includes a lot of passengers. So since it deals with a lot of passengers, we need proper safety management. So let's go to the category 4 aircraft basic configuration. For example, you take Airbus A380 as for example. Basically, it has a length of 72.72 meters and 24.09 is the wingspan at the moment. The upgrades and modification consist of two, which are expanding runway and apron level, and also opting open concept. Expanding runway and adding new apron, especially for the 4F aircraft. And opting open concept, this is a new concept that we are adding into the SX in order to reduce the congestion. Airfield upgrades and modification, what basically we are going to add two stands for 4F aircraft in the apron level, and followed by aero bridges. One aircraft handler to accommodate one aircraft at a time, and we are upgrading the current runway to accommodate as well. Airfield upgrades and modification includes expanding runway, as we said, adding a new apron and opting new open concept. Then that includes aircraft turnaround equipment and on-stand services, and opting open concept because we are accommodating new 4F aircraft, and then which means open concept reduces the congestion since it is reduces the taxiway. Let's talk about the aircraft turnaround equipment, especially for the 4F aircraft. The external equipment such as passenger step, catering loads, cargo loads, loaders, equipment loading, shuttle services for the passengers and crew members, wheelchair loading equipment, PCA, which disposal is strong. And this is the basic one for the turnaround timing. Turnaround time consists like the total is 2 hours for the more or less 2 hours for the 4F aircraft, and 48 plus minus 48 minutes for refueling, and 33 plus or minus for the loading unloading cargo, and 39 plus or minus 4 minutes for the loading cargo. And the new stand concept that we are doing is hybrid, as we said. This hybrid consists of the existing one, which means the existing one is linear, and we are doing another one which is linear, as you can see here. So the existing, as you said, is pure, and then the new concept we say is linear. So this would be the new expansion plan with the new apron level. As you see, the two stands, as we said, especially for the Code F aircraft, we will upgrade them. And then the updated ground handling equipment, which was made this. The existing ground handling area comes till here, but we have upgraded till the added two apron levels. Such as we know, all these ground handling equipments, such as pack steps, cargo loaders, PCBs, bridge disposal, pallet loaders, pack bridges, pushback truck, cargo loaders, and the fuel refueling, etc. The new runway expansion would be this existing runway. The new pavement strength would be asphalt concrete in order to be cost effective. We have expanded the runway to taken runway. The existing runway is 3.8 kilometers as we saw, and the width is 60 meters. So we are upgrading it to 4.3 kilometers in the new runway, which means we have added 500 meters in both of the sides, which means from runway 32 and runway 15. So runway 32 we have added 250 meters, and we have occupied this empty area and we have expanded it in order to accommodate effective operation and for the effective landing of 4F aircraft. And opting open concept, as we see, this is a bunch of land which is like empty. So we have used this particular land for opting open concept. So this would be the new open concept area where open concept will be having two aircraft stands. So the overview expansion plan for the airfield that we have seen the upgraded terminal, upgraded paper level, and upgraded open concept. So this will be the final plan for the overview and upgrade of SVZ and field layout. So I'll be passing to my colleague, Ilya.
After all the upgrades made to the terminal, we have to consider the most important thing, which are ORAD considerations. ORAD stands for Operational Readiness and Transition. It is a project method that ensures a smooth and efficient flow of operations. So when airport planning, certain elements have to be considered under ORAD in order to make this possible. Firstly, the factors include ground handling. Ground handling operations from check-in all the way until the customer boards the plane comes under ground handling. So they have to be in a certain process and done in a systematic way in order to run efficiently. Next, runway, taxiway, and apron areas. These also have to abide by ORAD considerations for it to be effective. Security practices. Because we are upgrading the terminal to accept 4F aircrafts, this in turn means we are accepting more passengers into the terminal, more passengers by number. So this means that security practices also should be tighter, because many frauds can happen, such as fake passports or stuff like that. And lastly, safety management services. This is paramount in every operation, so this has to be mentioned at last. To increase operational efficiency, we need to take into consideration a few factors. So this, in turn, reduces airport congestion. Because when increasing, when upgrading to a new terminal, which means we're accepting more passengers, it might lead to airport congestion. So in order to avoid that, we need to have effective ground handling, meaning the system should run systematically and it should have a reduction in passenger waiting time. Moreover, effective baggage handling as well, because there are many cases in the airports where baggage gets lost and this causes inconvenience to the passengers. So back-end infrastructure should be maintained at its optimum level. Lastly, airport strategies for opening and transfer. So when opening a new terminal, it is paramount that staff should be well-trained and equipped to be able to understand the new facilities that the new terminal entails. So they need to be trained and they need to be tested well before the opening date, or the AOD, the airport opening date. Next, mitigating startup risks. Because of the expansion of the aviation industry, most of the equipment used is technology-based and manpower is less. So because of this, this means that there is a higher risk for equipment to experience malfunction. So in order to avoid this, systems and procedures at the airport should be tested well before the opening date in order to prevent such inconveniences to the customers, to the passengers, sorry. Next comes transitioning and opening. On the opening day of the terminal, a list of sequences should be in order so that the efficiency, the operation of the airport runs smoothly. For example, 45 days before the opening date, there should be a countdown. Moreover, the staff at the airport should be given specific responsibilities and requirements to be done on that day and for the 2 weeks after the opening date of the aircraft to ensure smooth operation. Last is the sequence. So on the opening day as well, the sequencing of arrivals and departures of flights will be segregated, meaning the terminal will be open, but fractionally, not entirely. And last but not least, I have the train-the-trainer principle, or FIT, which means familiarization, induction, and training plan. As mentioned in the previous slide, the most important part about efficient operation of an airport is that the staff is well aware of the systems and how the system works. So in case on the opening day, the systems experience any sort of malfunction, the staff are trained as to know what to do as a plan B. So this is paramount in determining a smooth operation of the airport. I'm going to pass the next topic on to my colleague, Kriti.
So furthermore, I would like to go into depth about the ORAD sequencing program. And the first one is operational readiness view and evaluation. So operational readiness view and evaluation overlooks on the standard upgrading and contingency procedures. So for instance, take the case of aircraft during its landing phase. So while it's landing, due to lack of situational awareness that's resulting from communication errors between the pilot and the ATC, it leads to a non-precision approach. So while non-precision approach occurs, the pilot descends below 1,000 feet below the ground, that could result in crash, leading to some contingency procedures. Therefore, it's important for the airport to have a core team specialized just to reduce the risks of contingency procedures and to update the procedures regarding the airport documentation, such as the aerodrome's operation manual and other documents that are required. Then we have the airport is required to have a specific test, which is the Operational Integrated Validation Test, or IVT in short. So IVT focuses on the airside aspect of the airport, and IVT is a set of 14 tests that need to be taken in order to validate the operation procedures and to make sure that the airport is ready for its opening day. So there are many operational trials. How exactly are these trials conducted? The trials are involving the whole airport community as well as mock passengers. So mock passengers are randomly chosen from a given sample survey, and they are put under a simulated airport environment to check and challenge them against the different procedures and the new facilities that are being added into the airport. Then apart from IVT, we also have tabletop exercises, which are focusing on the emergency procedures. So tabletop exercises are the emergency procedures. So in case of mass evacuations during natural disasters or terrorist attacks, people should be prepared, mainly the airport users should be prepared to handle such situations. This here is a Wii model that's for project development, which can be incorporated into the operational readiness view and evaluation. On the left hand side, we have the test and integration aspects which need to be considered, and on the left hand side we have the activities that need to be taken, such as concept of operations and detailed design. Moving further, now that we're done with planning and updating the procedures, we move on to the transition plan, which is the last component of our ORAC sequencing program. So transition plan involves advanced planning and logistic management. This is approached logistics management, starting from workshop, analysis, planning, simulation, and implementation, leading to transition. Secondly, according to ORAD, it is necessary that the move activities, such as taking equipment from one place to the other place, should take before or after the airport opening date, so that the risks of the problems that can occur in the early phase can be reduced. Next, we have the ORAC considerations. This is basically a sequence of all the programs, starting with the definition. So definition, ORAC is a project method that is used by airports to ensure that the airport is ready for functioning. Then we have planning. So as Ms. Nelly explained about the airport strategy and familiarization for staff. And then we have the execution and acceptance that can be done through a series of tests like IVT or tabletop exercises. Moving further to activation and handover. So it will be activated, the processes and the new facilities also, leading to our main date, which is the airport opening date. Not to neglect the fact that we need a post support after the opening date of the airport, because even though all the risks have been mitigated, there are still chances that after the opening date there would be more number of problems that could arise. Therefore, we need a support team.